what's up? Knock, knock, knock on the door. It's time for makeup, perfect smile. It's you they're all waiting for. There you go.
I couldn't stand it. Now, of course, you are watching Squeal on Channel 31, Bent TV, your community station, and your community queer station probably too tonight, because you're all very, very lucky, as Brittany was chirping along, as I'm lucky, because I was born so beautiful. And we've got some beautiful people on... There's no need for laughter. We've got some lovely people on today, some very beautiful people. I'm going to introduce you to them right now. On the end, we have second time Squealer here, the lovely Rachel. Make Rachel welcome.
Hi. Hi, Mum.
Are you well, Rachel?
I'm very well, thanks, Tabitha.
You're looking very sexy today, young lady.
I can't help it.
You're a sexy young lesbian, I think, actually, darling. Is somebody in your life at the moment?
Yes, there is.
And we'll probe into that a little bit later on.
Right.
Next to Rachel, we've got Paul, and Paul is the station manager from Joy Melbourne. Welcome, Paul. Is it nice to have a bit of a break, and is it, you know, a bit different doing TV to radio?
It's my first time.
You're a virgin squealer. Mm. We'll do what we do to all the virgin squealers after the show, sweetheart. Is it a nice change coming in tonight? You've relaxed fine and...
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okie doke. Don't worry, I'm just being a mole. We've got Troy here, and Troy, you're an old slut here on Squeal. Have you had a lovely week?
Yeah, not too bad a week, actually. Not too bad a week at all.
And you visited the family on the weekend. How did that go?
Oh, it was good. I had the family over from Adelaide, the nana and the parents and the brother and fiancé, so the busload.
They'd love coming over here with our fresh water.
Yeah, they have to swallow.
And on the news desk, we have Aaron. Make Aaron welcome. Really large studio audience here today. It's very like IMT. We've got this large happening thing, but I look nothing like Frankie J. Thank God. Now, we've got some news. So please, Troy, would you like to start off with the
big news? Something that, you know, is quite close to my heart. It was about this school that banned 35 students for wearing hair product. Now, I mean, I would have no chance at this school, obviously, then, because I would have just said, stop you, I'm leaving.
It's shocking.
And literally, apparently there was 50 to 60 kids were sent home and had to write a letter of apology for wearing hair product.
No,
and 35
ridiculous.
35 of them were banned. They're not allowed to. Like, they did an inspection, and what they actually did is they went through and said, have you got hair product in there? This one guy that's been interviewed said no, and they actually put their fingers through the head. Meanwhile, I would have got a knife and stabbed you if you tried to put fingers through my head.
Oh, they fingered his hair.
Yeah. And so, and they got sent home and got banned. Like, how ridiculous is that?
I mean, in the 80s when prison was at its height, I mean, every girl, of course, wanted to look like Lou Kelly. With that, you know, that sense... And you cannot do a Lou Kelly without gel.
No, well, that's right.
I would dye my hair purple and tease the crap out of it every morning then just to harass these. Is it a public school or a private school?
It's a college.
It's a Catholic.
It's a
Catholic school. And I can't believe it either, because there's nothing wrong with the look of the hair. The style is really quite conservative. It's not like... Well, like when I saw the headlines, I thought, oh, well, maybe they're doing mohawks and shaving their hair, but...
Yeah. Well, this guy that's in here is just saying he actually needs to, otherwise his hair would be this big boof.
Boof, yeah.
Like, so he needs it to tone
down.
And
then he'll get picked on.
They said they want the students to look respectable, so he looks more respectable with doing it. Like, he just does it subtly. I mean, it's not as if he's got, like, orange hair like I do, sort of thing, which is a bit different.
Well, I think, too, when kids are sort of at school and growing up, why shouldn't they be allowed to do anything they want to their hair? Because when they start working, they're going to have to conform to a workplace look. Like, they're going to have to wear a suit or have their hair... Mm. I mean, most places now, they still want you to have... They won't let you have mohawks and bright pink hair. Yeah. So let them get out of their systems now. As long as they're doing their work, I don't see what the problem
is.
Anything else, my darling?
Oh, look, I'll leave it for that for now.
Fine. Rachel, darling heart, have you got something?
Well, I've got a few things, actually, but I'll just start with one thing. soon as they were on the topic of schools, I read in the paper this week that apparently cannabis use on school...
Your marijuana.
Oh, that would be the marijuana, yes.
Yeah.
Apparently doubles your chances of dropping out of high school. So for all you young teens out there, not only can you not use hair gel, but don't smoke dope either, okay?
Well, I don't think they're really short at high school.
I think they can wait. I mean, the dope, yeah, fine. Hey, don't smoke it.
But, I don't mind a little bit of underage drinking and a bit of tobacco smoking, but you can leave the green till you at least...
A little bit of raspberry lemonade, okay, but... You
yeah,
know, I mean,
and leave you, like, your little lolly biscuit, disco biscuits until you finish school too, don't you think?
Yes,
because some
definitely.
Of them do sound a bit young, and you know, you don't want them on, you know.
It's getting younger and younger these days, though. They're 13, 12 even.
I've actually decided now, Troy, I'm not going to have children now because I'm too scared of what it might do. And also had that shocking horse accident when I was younger. So.
Oh, is that it?
Paul, Dale, you got some news you'd like to share with us?
Yes. American Mark Meltz didn't lose his bride's wedding ring. He knew exactly where it was.
Yeah.
You know where it was? No.
Her ring?
Her wedding ring.
Oh, okay.
Yes, in his dog's stomach. And he handed the bride, Hilary Feinberg, an x-ray at the altar of a Boston church to prove it. Wedding guests giggled as Mr. Melt said his pet Labrador, Liza, had gobbled the ring after his cat knocked it off a counter.
That's fantastic.
His name's Mark Meltz. He's got a pet Labrador named Liza. And he's marrying Hilary.
But was that more than likely his cheap version of getting out this expensive ring? He's just gone one of those 20-cent machines, said to the doc, here you go, whack this down your throat, took an x-ray, said, see, there is a ring there.
But, you know, if there was a diamond in it, women will go through shit for a diamond. If there's no diamond in it...
Are you speaking of yourself?
Forget it. Yeah, exactly. If there's something of value in that shit, I don't care what I have to sift through, we'll find it somehow. Because we all like to look pretty. And now, after that lovely little thing about feces, we're going over to the news desk. With Aaron. Thank you, Aaron.
Thanks, Tabby. Coming up this Thursday at QBH to benefit the AIDS Trust of Australia, we have Circus Creature 2000. Tickets are available pre-purchase for $22 and at the door. Okay. Also benefiting the Melbourne Memorial AIDS Candlelight Vigil coming up on the 16th of September, next Saturday night.
Next Saturday. That's always very good every year. I find it's bigger and bigger, which is good.
Okay. And tomorrow at 6 p.m.
Just make a day
up, though. No, it's the S11. There is a queer component of the S11 protest for the World Economic Function at Crown Casino. So get along to that one. They need your support. And also, just for the kids, our pink pig, our motto here, our motto here at... thank you.
Oh, and thank you for that lovely close-up of my
face. I'm out of here.
Well, hello. It's Sportsman's Sky, and because I look like a
woman. Because I've had a lot of time kicking the balls. Now, we're going to have a quick chat to Paul. Paul, you are station manager of Joy Melbourne. Is it an enjoyable job?
It's a great job. One of the best jobs.
Yeah? What were you doing before that?
I was studying full-time, but... Prior to that, I worked in the health industry and community health. And
was radio something you always wanted to get involved with, or how did that sort of come about?
No, I wanted to get involved in a gay and lesbian community organisation. I'd worked in some previously in the AIDS field, and I saw the job advertised in Brother and Sister or MSO and put in an application and got the job.
Voila, it all happened. Now, sweetheart... I want to know, how many people, do you want me to spit it out properly? How many people listen to Joy Melbourne?
How many people?
Is there any way to gauge it?
We estimate about 100,000 people will tune in over a 4-day broadcast.
Okay.
But how do you estimate that? How do you gauge?
You take the standard measure that 10% of the population are gay or lesbian.
Yeah.
Okay, so in Melbourne you're looking at 310,000 people.
Okay.
We would then say that, okay, only a certain percentage would listen to radio, and then only a certain percentage who listen to radio listen to us.
Because it's a very diverse station where you've got But you know what I mean? Like, some people might just like, say, one commercial station because they play just rock music, or they just play just dance music, or they play top 40 hits. But you have sort of like a bit of everything. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? So I don't know if that makes a difference in, you know, getting people to tune in.
I think that it can make a difference in terms of, it's much easier for a lot of people to tune into. Easy listening is tuning into a radio station that just plays the same thing, you know what to expect, 24 hours a day.
Dribble for it.
Okay. With us, I mean, we're trying to reflect, and we are reflecting the diversity of our community.
And now, the presenters paid, now is everything still voluntary?
I'm a full-time paid employee.
Yeah.
There are three other staff, paid staff, and then every on-air person is a volunteer presenter.
Well, yeah, it's
so hard. Tell us, D-Day, when is it, and how's the chances?
Well, you can tell me, no. Look, we have an idea, because we know that we're following the Sydney licensing process, and they've been doing the same thing to allocate the last few frequencies in Sydney. And the Sydney process has just gone through public hearings. We're about 6 months behind Sydney, we believe. We expect them to call for applications, that is physical documents going into them to say we want a license and this is why, and to show the support from the community that we've got. And that should be in the next 8 weeks or so. So we estimate by probably October. End of October.
You'll know whether or not you'll be guaranteed full-time license.
No. Not at all. An application process.
Is that all? Oh, my God.
So there's a few months.
Is this the first in the line of the process? Or
no,
have you been doing this constantly?
Look, it really started last December. Mm. Last December we got the first information. They issued a draft license area plan saying this is what we want to do with the frequencies in Melbourne.
Now, can people help out by doing anything? Can they,
yep.
Can they write letters or memberships? I mean, what can people do out there? Like,
look, the clear thing that would support us is for people to become members of the station.
And what does that involve? What does that, you know, what do you have to do?
You ring the station or you go to our website. It's $40 full membership. $25 concession
for a year,
mm-hmm. under 18, so $20. We have those membership numbers that we have will help get us across the line with a license. The reason being that we need to show them that we have support. We can estimate that we have 100,000
But you've got to
listeners.
Give them proof, understandable.
Yeah.
So what's like behind the scenes? Because, I mean, you know, here at Ben TV, we don't have many dramas or, you know, stuff like
that.
We're
many.
Always running on time. No prima dramas. Like, is there anything like that with Joy?
What I'm going to do, I'm going to ask you to come back because we've got more to talk about. Would you like to come back in the next segment?
Right.
We'd love to have you back. What we're going to do now is we're going to have a small little break. So, boys and girls, mums and dads, ones you just find me really attractive, go and make yourself a cup of coffee, have a bit of a relax. We'll be back with you very soon. Ben TV.
Yay!
Get you by, and when you're down, just listen.